Hey friends, it's Mike, the Hi-Fi Insider. Today I'm going to review for you the new Estelle & Kern SP2000T digital music player. I did an unboxing video on this player. If you haven't watched that yet, I urge you to take a look there first. That way you can see the product up close and also see what comes in the box so you know what to expect when you buy it. To bring you guys back in time just a little bit, Estelle & Kern was the first high-end audio company to introduce a high-end music player for the audiophile community. It was the AK120, I think it was the K120 or something like that, but this is the player that they introduced. When in the world of music players that is dominated by the iPod. Now right off the top, I have to say, I don't know how AK can top this one. Because the SP2000T, it is so incredible in terms of performance and features. I've been using the SP2000 for over a month with my Dynafi reference headphone. This headphone I use to evaluate electronics because it is very transparent. Before we go into some of the advanced features that this player has, I want to tell you guys about the sound quality first. This music comes through so enjoyable, very musical. You can feel the emotions in the music. I don't like to talk about, you know, specific treble or mids or bass. I like to talk about the experience as a whole because we don't listen to music by frequencies. So when I listen to well-recorded music, the player was able to shine through, was able to tell me that this is very high dynamic range, very good recording. There's very little compression. When I'm listening to lower quality recordings, this player still gives me a lot of information, but it's also very musical still. So it didn't really made it too analytical where it becomes unlistenable. And this is a trait that high-end music systems as a whole would deliver, that you know, you can listen to a wide range of recordings. It doesn't matter how amazing the recording is. Certainly the better the recording, the better it will sound, but lower quality recordings should also sound very musical, very enjoyable. You can actually imagine yourself being in the live performance. The SP2000 is very refined in terms of every minute detail. You can hear the soundstage is very wide, very open. So it's not a narrow soundstage compared to lower grade music players. And this is something that you really need a high-end headphone or IEM to be able to experience this level of fidelity. So I really think that this player is, in my opinion, the last high-end music player you will probably need to own until the next level in high resolution music players. Maybe, you know, the next level would be completely wireless, for example, right? The SP2000 does have support for streaming music services. I tested it with Tidal. I am not really a fan of streaming music services as a whole. But certainly, you know, now just about every one of them except Spotify supports lossless audio. So the marquee feature of this player is the ability to change the output amplifier between vacuum tube or solid state or a mix of both in between. This was a lot of fun playing with because a lot of times different genre of music, I prefer a different type of sound signature. So for example, if I'm listening to jazz music like Pink Martini, I like a little bit more romantic sound to it. So I like the tube setting. Or if you're listening to rock and roll music, I like a little bit more snappy, a little bit more dynamic, more punchy, not as rolled off as tubes, I would change it to solid state output. Another thing that I really like about these DAPs now is that it can also be used as a DAC slash headphone amplifier with your computer or your tablet. So if you're on the go, you no longer need to carry a dedicated headphone amplifier with you anymore, like back in the day. This player can double duty as a high-end DAC amp for your laptop. I think that the SP2000 is going to be a long-term keeper for a lot of enthusiasts like you and I. Just like the AK120, you know, this thing is over 10 years old now. So it's still running really, really strong. And this is going to be an investment that I think you'll enjoy for a long, long time, or even pass it down to your kids if you have, you know, really young kids now. And 10 years from now, they become teenagers and they are getting into audio. If you like the content on this channel, please consider using our Amazon link. Thanks for watching, and I'll see everyone in my next video. Bye-bye.